you. This is the unique feature of the Imperative magazine. And today, we're sitting with a man who needs no introduction. All right? His name is Donald. Do you still have to say your name, or we can just say he's here?
You can call me. I've got a lot of names, but
yeah,
you can call me Donald, Mr. Red Mike.
Yeah, let's talk about the mic. What made you get that red mic that's just your mic? Like, what does it mean when you have that mic?
You know, the red mic is more than just a microphone. Mm-hmm. For me, it's a symbol of how I connect with my fans.
Okay.
I brought in that mic, honestly, as a fashion type of thing. To say, as much as I can look a certain, you know, and wear some nice suits and all of that, I also have an extra element in what I do.
Yeah.
You know, because I regard myself as a live artist.
I'm
a stage artist.
Yeah,
you know, I love to be seen on stage performing. So a microphone for me is that way that you connect and communicate with your audience.
You didn't have to be raised.
Honestly, the color came from the fact that I just wanted a color that can stand out.
So there wasn't any specific reason. Okay.
Red will always stand out. So
yeah.
And I'm glad that I came up with that.
Yeah.
I introduced it in 2013.
Yes, yeah.
At the Summers.
Mm-hmm.
I was performing for the first time at the Summers, and I performed with this mic, and I remember people had a lot to say on social media
about that
because I was the only one that had like a very different thing.
Yeah.
Very special.
It's very special. Yeah. I could see that. But with the connection that you're referring to, right, when you're connecting to the people that you're singing to, your fans or these new people or whatever, there's somewhere, Donald, where you go, right? Because I said in your performance, there's a part where you go deeper into that. And where is that space where you go into?
Can I take off my shades for this one?
Yeah.
Because you see my eyes. You know, I always say music for me is a way of life. You know, I don't just make music because I need to pay bills.
Mm.
And I mean, the truth is, you know, there's some bills to be paid.
Yes.
You know, at the end of the day, you know,
we do
need to make a living. However, for me, music is a little bit much bigger than that. You know, it runs in my veins. It almost sort of kind of controls how my life is set up.
Yeah.
And reason for that is because I've always regarded my music talent as more of a calling than it just being a passion.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
I feel like God came into my life and really chose me amongst other people and said, you are going to be a messenger.
Yeah.
And this is how you're going to spread energy, spread love through your musical talent. And I've accepted that, that calling with both hands. So for me, every time I'm on stage, I always want to make sure that it's a spiritual affair.
And
I'm not a gospel artist or whatever.
Yes, yeah.
However, I regard myself as a love healer.
Yes.
You know, I heal through love, message of love, because love is possibly the most powerful force.
Yeah.
In humanity.
And it's quite universal.
Yes,
it doesn't matter where you are.
You feel it. You know, you perform for. For people in Europe, they're still going to understand exactly what it is that I'm feeling. And that's why I've got moments where I go deeper, and I never know when that's going to happen. It just happens because, like I said, this is not just me making music and singing songs.
Yeah,
I actually, you know, there's a huge purpose in me doing this. And it doesn't matter whether I perform for 5 people.
Yeah.
Or 50,000 people.
Yeah,
it's just the same.
So at that time when you go somewhere, right? What do you hope for the people that you see?
I don't hope.
Mm-hmm.
I don't hope. I just go there.
You just go there,
and
you know
it has never happened that they don't come.
Yeah,
because remember we ultimately as human beings, all of us are spiritual beings.
Yes. Yeah.
You know, I don't care who you are. The minute once the spirit catches you, it catches you.
Yeah.
Music is powerful. It has that thing.
It
will catch you off guard sometimes.
And then you'll find yourself.
You find yourself there, and you don't know why you're behaving that way.
Yeah.
And I think that's why I always have that type. My crowd is always the crowd that does things, and they don't know why. It just goes like, if I show you some of my recent videos.
Yes, yeah.
It's like it's always mayhem. It's always crazy. It's worse if it's like younger
yes,
kids, like
yeah.
schools. Like if I go to schools, it becomes a mess, you know. But I understand, I know where that comes from.
Okay.
It comes from the fact that the people know when it's genuine. People know when the music comes from a good place.
Yes, yeah.
And they also know when the music is meant to make a lasting impact, you know. And I think that's probably part of the reason why some of my older songs still touch that
they
spot.
Still resonate now.
They still touch
the spot. Yeah. And it's so funny, and I was saying with the people that I was sitting with that we check with every song that you're singing, especially with the love. I knew where I was. I knew what club I was at that time. So you'll always travel.
Takes you back.
Takes you back, right?
It's a nostalgic moment.
It is.
Yeah, performing for Matriculant 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
In Bloemfontein.
Yeah.
You can go back to 2011-12.
Mm-hmm.
That's 7 years ago,
yeah.
8 years ago. Go back there and do the math.
Yeah.
Ask yourself, how old were those kids when I Deserve came out?
Yeah, they were probably in the 10 years, 11 years.
They were in primary school.
Yes, yeah.
They're singing that song like it came out yesterday.
Wow.
So that for me is like, that is what's like, it makes me think, oh my gosh.
Mm.
So my music has that type of impact in people, in kids.
Yes, yeah. And you see that.
Yes,
yeah.
Because it has lasted in them for that long.
For that long,
you know.
Yeah.
So for me, that is crazy because for them, they never got to go to the club.
Yeah,
the
way, I was at the club.
You were in
the
club, so
you
always take
it
back to the
memory
of, oh my gosh, I remember chilling with all my cousins and we were drinking and it was just fun and the song was...
Taking us there. So
for me, that's just what it is, man. Just
the
power of music.
Nice. So you sing a lot about emotions. What do you think the purpose of emotions are in our lives?
I think emotions are meant to get us to know ourselves a little better.
Okay.
We tend to ignore what we feel a lot because we have this thing. We grew up, I guess, being told that if you feel too much or if you show your feelings or emotions too much, that means you are weak.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
However,
yeah.
The truth is all of us feel something. And,
yeah.
And that also includes guys. Like guys are emotional beings too.
Yeah.
We never get to speak about that because you know we meant to be hard like that, you know? But I think with an artist like me, I brought in a different element because it has allowed Amajita to also be able to express themselves with their girls through my lyrics and my music will force you to be soft whether you like it or not.
There's no way to
it'll force you to have a soft moment.
Soft
you can't be too much of when a Donald song is on. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
You know, so I think for me that's what, you know, having emotions means just allowing yourself to get to know you a little bit better. Because that you time is important.
Saying that having that you time is important, I see that, right? Because you cannot go out on stage and serve people if you have not connected with yourself.
100%.
And I like what you said as well before we started. And I said to you, I want to talk to you as Donald the musician and Donald the guy. Any guy that I'll meet on the street. And you said, no, it's a center. I don't go out and act. I wear that, right?
Yeah, it's wear.
It's who you are.
Yeah.
So there's no.
I think what is not me is the famous guy.
Okay.
You see that guy? Because you see, there's who I am, and then there's what people have made me to be.
Okay.
It's an image then.
Yeah.
So it's not real.
Yeah.
That is something else altogether. You see that I can't control that. I'm not in control.
How do you step in and out of that? Like, are you aware
I'm
now in the mall, this is what can happen, or are you so...
No. You see, okay, so the awareness of knowing, okay, cool, this is the impact that I have made to people, that awareness will always be there.
Okay.
However, what I'm saying is, there's a certain image people have of Donna.
Oh, yes.
Which is their image.
Yes.
If those are their thoughts. That's not who I am.
And you can't own that.
No, I can't.
Okay.
Because I also can't control it.
Yeah.
So that part is just, it's just a character on its own that just does what it does.
Okay.
I mean, on the other hand, what I actually do on a daily basis is really who I am.
Okay.
Like, I just move as me.
Yeah.
I do the things that I want to do.
Okay.
You know, and this is why I think sometimes sometimes it's a bit of a clash when I interact with people like live, and then maybe someone catches me in like I'm not in a great chest of moods or whatever, and then maybe Lebo and I, they come with the wrong approach. Like, you know, I'm just that type of a guy. If you come with the wrong approach,
you're just gonna be like, and then
if you come with the wrong approach,
yeah,
it's not gonna work out.
That door. Yeah,
yeah, because yeah. And because I'm not acting, I can't act.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I can't act like I'm happy with your approach, whether I'm actually not.
Yeah. Also, you're gonna call it out.
So I might call it out, but I've got a way to call it out that it doesn't make the next person feel like I'm attacking them.
Okay.
Also.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's where the clash comes in
a bit.
Because Bona, they expect, which they're gonna find the guy that they've created in their head.
Do people ask you to take off your shirt?
Yeah, no, people ask me all sorts of things.
Not on stage.
People ask me to take off my shirt.
Do you do it?
People know. You see, those things are not practical. It's not practical because I take off my shirt on stage.
Yeah.
As part of the act.
Yes.
It's an act, and I do it ballet also in the spirit of the situation.
Yes,
you know?
Yeah.
So I can't just willy nilly go pick and pay.
Come with an onion.
You got me. You know what I mean? So, so it's that thing, and that's why I was saying I can't really separate the two.
Okay.
Because it's not, you know, I'm not really trying to be someone else
when I
when I step up.
But this is the important thing that I want us to talk about, Donald. There's a moment where you speak up. I can't remember who was interviewing you, right? You were saying you were in a taxi and you heard your song play. And you're like, hey, let's get cool here. Because, hey, we can't be showing people that I'm the one singing this song. And then this is
because I'm in a taxi.
You're in a taxi.
And
you
people expect,
say, that's my song.
And people expect, if my song's playing on the radio,
yeah,
I should have my
be
car.
In the taxi.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, those are the days. I think those are the beginning, you know, those are really like very honest times, innocent times in my life, hungry, you know, really just wanting to make it so bad. I remember that moment like it was yesterday, actually, because I was still I had a car accident a few months before that. And that's actually how the song came. The story behind I Deserve is that I had a car accident, and then me and my ex-girlfriend at the time had issues because she didn't come to the hospital
to see me. I remember,
and then I was really broken by that, and I caught feelings like, this girl, I've done like, everything for this chick, you know, and now I get a car accident, you know, with my small car, the car is messed up, she doesn't come to check me, she's making excuses, and then I got mad and I broke up with her, and then I wrote the song.
And then the song
And then the song blew up.
You were like,
now when it blew up, I didn't have a car, so I was taking taxis.
Okay.
And how the music industry works is that you can have your song play on the radio for 4, 5, 6 months sometimes.
Yes, yeah.
But still, you're not getting booked.
Yeah.
Like, promoters don't think you are worth the money yet. And this is what I always tell young artists who are coming up. Don't think because you got an interview on your TV now is singing in the manji. It was the money. Now you're fighting with the manager now. It was the money. Why are we not? You understand? Because it doesn't work like that. You know, you have to
A process.
And it's a long process. You need patience.
Yeah.
You know? So I had to be patient while my song was playing and it was getting popular.
Yeah.
But I wasn't popular yet. Maybe.
Yeah.
You know, I wasn't yet on TV as much. My video wasn't on rotation as much.
Yes,
so people didn't know who I was, but they knew the song already. So it was a great moment. But it was also I was satisfied at that moment because then I could see where I was going.
So you were seeing the reward.
I was seeing
the hard work.
I was seeing
the
light. At the end of the tunnel.
Okay.
Yeah.
When you see where you are now, right, and where you come from, and you might not want to own it, but then there's wealth, there's a sense of wealth that you've created, right? What has wealth enabled you to do in your personality and as your spiritual being?
So wealth, with regards to money, I still have a love and hate relationship with that wealth, you know? Because I think the concept of money is still a very tough one for me to understand, the importance and how we need to treat it and all that. So I'm not very big on that conversation for now. because money is just a very fickle thing. It comes and it goes, and you know, and some people make it in good ways, some people make it in bad ways.
Yeah.
You know, it's money. However, the other wealth that I feel like I've really achieved with my success is the wealth of really just self-realization.
Okay.
And understanding myself a little bit better. I think being successful has humbled me more, actually. Because I remember when I was younger, I used to have a chip on my shoulder. Because I used to be like, you know what, I'm this guy.
Yeah.
Talented.
Yeah.
Can't touch me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, people like me, girls like me. You know, you can't do
anything. Then they throw all sort of things at you.
You know?
Yeah.
But I think being successful does, in a way, humble you.
Okay.
Well, for me, at least it did. Because also, I started having this fear of losing it all.
Oh,
you know, you have it and you just keep it. What if I wake up tomorrow and it's gone? Because people start, in a way, kind of start looking at you as your wealth and not just you as you are.
Yes, yeah.
People judge you from what they think you have. And that's
what they can get from you as well.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Now, and that's part of the reason why I decided early on in my career that I'm not going to be the artist that shows off too much of what I have achieved, the physical things,
okay,
like the cars, the houses, this, I've got this business, I've got this watch, I just bought this new watch, what this, like I'm just not that guy. You will never see any of it.
Yeah.
You know, I've never posted my car once.
Okay.
And I think I drive a really nice car.
Okay.
But I've never.
You won't tell us what it is.
People see me at the robot.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, damn.
Yeah.
He drives that.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
But my problem was, what happens when they see me and I'm now in an Uno? Because that can happen. That's life.
Yeah.
Life can hit and I lose my beautiful car and now I have to downgrade to something else. And this is why I didn't want to make it.
Okay.
I didn't want.
And you would feel attached to it.
Yeah.
And so when you don't have it, you'd feel less of a being.
Yes.
Because
especially because of how people look at me.
Yes.
People see me and they see the success. So now without the success, that means I'm not me. So I've always kind of said, you know what? I want my wealth to be inward.
Okay.
You know, because whether I have money or not, you're always going to get the same guy. You're always going to get the same substance from me. Because when I speak, I'll speak the same, you know, progression. That's me. My mind, for me, my mind and my heart and my spirit is where my power lies.
Okay.
And not all the awards and
all
what people think.
Yeah,
because
those are the affirmation of the process that you've been into, right?
Yeah.
Without the process, you would not have gotten there, right? And before we wrap up, thank you so much for being here, right? Because your words of wisdom will transform a next Donald elsewhere. People know where to find you, right? But where to be found?
Yeah, you can find me. I mean, social media right now is the way for us to connect. It make life easier for a lot of us.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of other things that are not very important that are flying around social media.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, social media on Twitter, Donald in Denial, Instagram, Donald in Denial, Facebook, I have a fan page called Donald. And yeah, man, I personally interact myself. I don't let my manager do that.
Do that,
I personally interact with
you. Great. Yeah, so we have a ritual here, right? As we wrapping up, we're going to ask you these beautiful questions. If you don't have a chance, not even you have a second to think about, you can't say no.
Okay, cool. Let me wear my shades for this one. Let me see if I can
Let's go
for this.
So love is?
Love is God.
Love is God.
Yeah.
Fear is?
Fear is nothing.
It's nothing. Faith is.
Faith is hope.
Spirit is.
Spirit is me.
Spirit is you. And you
I am love.
So much.
I killed that.
Mr. Love.
Did I kill that?
You did.
Come on. The love I know I deserve. The love I know I deserve. The
You know I deserve. I gave you the best. I showed you that I care. I just can't pretend. Remember the time we shared all we had. The tears and the joy. Good times and bad times. Just want you to know I can feel it in my heart.